Everyone, welcome to round two. We've lost the roll and are on our way to winning with GTA yet again. And our opponent has chosen a mulligan on the six. Would we like to mulligan? And no, I don't think so. I like GTA. I like equipping it to creatures. And I like casting all of those spells. And so we've got all that combination, which works out for us. We're going to go ahead and start off with the plains, then either play Canonist or GTA. Night's Whispers. Well, I think we're going to go ahead and stick with the Canonist here. The other option would be to play this and protect ourselves from some sort of artifact discard or from some discard, but I think I'm just going to get this into play because it beats down for two, and I like beating down. Ooh. Mox Diamond, would that have been good last turn? Who knows? Well, I'm gonna hold that in my hand for now. I'm just gonna attack and play a Blade Splicer. Dun, 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 dun. Awesome. Blade Splicer's gonna be able to attack their treetop village. And I mean, we also have Fiend Hunter, and yeah, if we draw a land, we're in really good shape. I don't play the Mox Diamond because of Mortar or something like Deed or Putrid, or yeah, Frequently, yeah, that's realistic. An awesome draw for us would be a land, so we can smash his face down. And we're going to equip it to our first striking creature and attack with everything, I think. Yeah, because even if he steps in front of our Blade Splicer, then we still have the option of giving this minus one, and trading with it, which I am more than inclined to do. So we're going to teach him about the stack. Watch this. First strike resolves, GT gets two counters, he gets minus one. Always yield to that. And remove a counter, target creature gets minus one. Hey, look! Look, I still have a counter. Where does creature go? It has two toughness. What's going on? I mean, Slaughter Pact would have been bad and resulted in the Canonist dying, but like that's not really too much of an issue. Ooh, looks like we've got some sort of junk deck over here. Splashing Night's Whisper, perhaps? Or is he splashing white? Who knows? And we're casting something. Looks like an X. No, hold on. Undo. There we go. He's got to leave Path to Exile up. T T T T T T T T T T T T T. Okay, I guess we're not casting anything. Loxodon Hierarch. Oh, there's something interesting. So we can do the same thing again, I think. Wake Thresher, that's pretty sick. I'm probably just going to attack with this guy, attack with this guy. Is that good? That's probably good enough. I can play this guy, but that's just trades. And yeah. I'd rather save my path for something more menacing. And unless this guy actually has Swords of Plowshares, because our last opponent had Condemn. Then I don't have too much to worry about. I do think I want to keep my Canonist in play though, since it's unclear whether or not he's trying to cast two spells per turn, and therefore how much this is screwing him. I mean, I'm fine casting just one spell, like, I'm not really going to path this, and I could rather save it for something scary like Elesh Norn. And Wake Thresher is just going to be a giant beating for this turn. Yes, you may block. Block away. Do you wish to repeat the process from last turn? Wait, hold on. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and let First Strike resolve. Then give you minus one. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna just play this Wake Thresher. Like, I mean, we have. I mean, alternatively, I can Fiend Hunter my Blade Splicer just in case he has a Wrath of God. I don't know how I feel about that. I mean, that's kind of interesting. Because we'll still have 6 and 7, 8, 9, 10. So, I mean, playing Wake Thresher here may be a bad idea. Yeah, I mean, that's interesting to think about. I mean, if he has a, like a 6 mana Wrath of God, for example. Yeah, I mean, I think that's worth trying out. I am crazy. So let's try this. All right. Recurring Nightmare. You have a Recurring Nightmare. His best option is to turn Treetop Village into a creature and get back his Loxodon Hierarch, which I am more than happy to let him do. We have two counters on our Jitte, which means that. Which was one more than we had last time, so I'm all for him doing this because he really does not do much by setting himself back and a turn. He says, "Oh, Canonist," and I say, "Yes, Canonist can be annoying at times." All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start our turn. I think we can go ahead and move this over to our Canonist so that we don't have to use two counters on the Jitte. So let's go ahead and equip there. Think. And attack. Now he can turn his guy into a creature, which I'm fine with doing. Well, I'm fine with him doing, because not only will he take a pain and be tapped out of white mana to first Lords of Plowshares, but we've got two counters, so we'll be able to kill the tree. We'll be able to shrink the Treetop Village down to a 1/1 if he blocks this guy. If he blocks this guy, then I can still use two counters on it and end up with two counters. And so he ends up being in a little bit of trouble. So I'm just going to go ahead and play Wake Thresher here, I think. And threaten to smash his face in. Now, him having seen the Jitte makes me kind of want to board out Mox Diamond, just because if he does have Deed, or if he board has a ton of artifact destruction, then Sovereign Lord of Innistrad. No, that's not quite going to do it. Then we might catch a little bit. All right, so he's probably going to supersize his guy. Yeah, all right. He's gaining some life. So, what's going to happen here? He's at 12. We're going to stack our triggers. Auto yield to all that nonsense. Let's say we don't. Okay, so yeah. Don't even have to show him the path. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like we have very much good sight in. Let's take a look at all this stuff. Yeah, I mean, you can board in some various mass decor action, but I don't like that nearly as much. I'd rather just keep it the way it is. If he has a bunch of artifact destruction, then playing mass decors doesn't seem like it's going to be that great. Especially if it's the Razor Man. I mean, if he has artifact destruction, I'd rather be able to regenerate potentially. We could bring in Glorious Anthem.